The views expressed on this show are the best views ever because they're from me and I'm tremendous. And the ratings on this particular... Why is there a fucking chicken on the screen?
Hello, world, and welcome to a special edition of What the Cluck. I'm your host, Vin A, and I'm beyond honored to announce we have the President of the United States and leader of the so-called free world with us, Donald J. Trump.
Huge.
Today. Wow. So glad he was able to fit us in between all the important executive time and golf outings. We'll get to him very shortly, but first, let's take a look at some headlines. First up, the headline reads, Sri Lankans ask UK to take back rotten waste. And no, I'm not talking about the boy band One Direction. Eesh. And that direction certainly isn't straight, by the way. I'm talking about actual British garbage that is exported to the third world country for recycling, but not really. 111 containers consisting of plastics, syringes, and suspected human remains were sent to Sri Lanka from the UK in 2017, but were only inspected last week after port officials complained of a putrid smell. Can you begin to fathom the extent of that kind of smell? I'm from New York, and I thought I knew the definition of putrid. I'm just kidding.
I'm just kidding, Donnie.
Many countries, however, are guilty of partaking in the global trash trade, including our own. Except we spend extra in shipping and send our trash to Cambodia.
Nothing wrong with that.
First we dump bombs, now we dump trash. Sorry, Cambodia, Florida's filled to capacity. Womp womp. Next up, Robert Mueller, head of the special counsel.
Loser!
Or one of the old guys from the Muppets, if you prefer, just recently testified on Capitol Hill for both the Judiciary and Intelligence Committees. Everyone thought this was going to be a bombshell day of new evidence and shocking revelations. Instead, it was a showing of what happens when you forget to take your Alzheimer's medication.
Can you repeat the question, sir? You're going to have to repeat that for me. Can you repeat the last part of that question?
Yeah. Pardon?
Can you read the last question?
Wow. We gave the most important job in our country to Mr. Magoo. Now, I'm not saying this man isn't a hero and true patriot. He is. And so is Jimmy Carter. But I wouldn't make Jimmy Carter head of mission control at NASA at the age of 110. I'd trust him to build a house or take a group of senior citizens to Old Country Buffet for the early bird special. But I wouldn't put the weight of the free world on someone's shoulders if they go to bed by 8 p.m. That's all I'm saying. Lastly, someone needs to tell me why every pair of jeans I own have to get repaired in the crotch area. It's like a conspiracy. I spend more money on restitching my groin than the actual jeans. We all have to bend down and tie our shoes. We all have to bend down when we drop something. We all deserve fully functional jeans. I don't want to worry every time I go to tie my shoe in public that my junk is going to make a surprise appearance. Now, I know exactly how Lenny Kravitz felt on stage. That one time, he bent down a little too much. The sad thing for him and the entire crowd is that he wasn't wearing any underwear.
Fake news.
Talk about American. Whoa, man. I finally figured out why this was happening to all my jeans when I read the tag on them. It said, made in Cambodia. Damn, sneaky Cambodians. Okay, we have a great show in store for you. I wanted to keep that monologue short because I want to get to the president. I'm beyond excited. Let's head over to our executive couch area and get it going.
Yeah, I tried to warn ya.
What the cluck? I have the President of the United States here, Mr. Donald Trump. Thank you for coming on.
Donald J. Trump.
Donald J. Trump. I'm sorry about that.
Thank you, Vinay. Yeah. Vinay.
I don't know whether to shake your hand, salute you, or subpoena you.
Well, let's shake. Subpoenas, I don't like subpoenas. I don't like subpoenas.
Yeah, nobody likes to spell
them. Nobody likes those.
No.
I wouldn't get one anyway.
Well, thank you for coming on the show. I'm a little nervous. I've never had a guest as prestigious as you, so I thank you
probably
for coming on.
Probably the biggest guest you've ever had. I've seen some of the hack people you've had on. So
yeah,
this is a big deal.
We don't get the best people like you.
Well, you know, so. These things happen. But the ratings after this show, through the roof.
That's
through the roof.
Hoping.
You're going to go national.
That's
you're going to go
hoping.
National.
We need sponsors.
International.
We
international.
Need sponsors.
I'll talk to Putin. We'll get you on in Russia.
Thank you. We'll get Chick-fil-A. We'll get a bunch of cool people.
Big names. Big names.
Cool. Very cool. Well, let's go on with this interview. I'm really excited to learn some of these great things about you. First question, sir, were you happy with the recent Mueller testimony?
Well, I thought he was terrible. He was old. You know, he's only like 2 years older than me, but doesn't he seem so much older?
He definitely didn't do good at that.
It was horrible. And I have to say, that whole report is a big fat hoax, other than the part where it says I'm totally exonerated and there's no obstruction. Other than that, it was a bunch of crap.
Yeah.
You know, those two parts are the most important. He's terrible. He's old. He never liked me.
He never liked me.
And what has he done, really? I mean, he was in the Marines, and he was in Vietnam, and he ran the CIA, the FBI. But other than that, he hasn't really done anything.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
He hasn't built anything.
He hasn't built anything. I bet you he hasn't built a treehouse.
Yeah.
Nothing at all.
Yeah.
So he's off my list.
He's off your list.
He's off my list. No Christmas card for the Trumps for Robert Mueller.
Yeah. Well, the good thing is the obstruction charges, they're like only in the low double digits.
Mm-hmm.
So that's pretty good.
That's very good.
That is pretty
good. That's very good. And I'll be reelected,
digits.
So that'll never happen.
That's pretty good.
I'll be reelected. You know?
You're going to be reelected.
I am. It's going to be. And we already figured out how.
I know.
Because
we're
getting rid of the Electoral College and we're replacing it with Trump University. It's going to be incredible.
I think that's a great idea.
Maybe 2 terms, 3 terms, 4 terms, president for life.
I wanted to ask you that question, actually, because a lot of the so-called lefties, the liberals, they think that you want to be president forever.
My question to you is,
would you want to?
I would love to be president for life. And, you know, all we'd have to do is change the Constitution, which is very easy.
No biggie. We've been doing that for 2 years.
All the time. A lot of the liberals
what
say...
What Constitution?
I don't even know what the Constitution is. That's not true. I know all 10 of the commandments. They're very easy to change. We can make that happen. And then I would be president for life. And, in fact, one of your liberal friends very recently came up to me and said, I hope you get life. Isn't that nice? So
that
even the
nice.
Liberals want
they
it.
Give
even
you
the
life.
Liberals,
that's,
they want to give me
so
life.
Cute.
That's a good thing. And I would be a tremendous lifetime president like Putin and Kim Jong-un and some of the other wonderful
your
leaders
friends,
we
yeah,
have.
Your,
yeah,
your squad.
Xi Jinping.
Your squad.
My squad.
Yeah.
My squad.
Your squad.
Not AOC plus three. My squad.
Yeah.
Xi Jinping doing a great job in China. By the way, China's killing us. They're absolutely killing us. Terrible people, the Chinese. Great takeout. Terrible people.
Food. The food is very
excellent,
good.
Isn't it?
Speaking of food,
did you notice that General So's and Kentucky Fried Chicken has a colonel? Why are chickens so militaristic? Why are they so military? Why do you need a general and a colonel? Does anyone know why?
That is like the most genius thing I've heard you say.
Thank
in
you.
Years.
Thank you.
That's
thank you. We're
going
to have an investigation.
We're going to look into that.
We're
going to
have an investigation
into
the colonel and to the general, and we're going to find out why Obama got a book deal. We're going to have an investigation of that.
You're going to get a movie deal. Are you kidding me?
Don't worry about that. Absolutely. Serious.
Not even.
Serious.
Speaking of food, I wanted to know everyone knows you happen to love fast food.
Thank
I mean,
you.
Who
so
doesn't
good.
Besides healthy and skinny people?
McDonald's bathrooms are so clean.
Yeah. They are. What's your favorite fast food restaurant, and what meal do you like to order?
Well,
all our MAGA fans want to know.
Well, I think I like McDonald's because it's so close to my name. You take the MC out, it's Donald's, so that's kind of perfect. And I love burgers. And I love burgers.
This guy's a genius. Like, his speeches should be this incredible.
It's Donald's.
Wow.
It's incredible. And then you have the KFC, which I love. I love the chicken.
Who doesn't?
So who like? I like the balance. I like the balance of the burgers and the chicken. I'm not a pizza guy, but I do like Domino's because it's doughy and it fills you up.
That's nice.
Well, that's good. But I'd say on the fly, I'm a McDonald's guy.
Very
you
nice.
Know?
They should make the
McMaga
burger.
They should make, oh, wow.
They should make the McMaga.
That's a great idea. The McMaga.
Just
that'd
give me 10% and we can
absolutely.
Make that happen.
Absolutely. It's your idea.
I know. I
always credit people with their ideas, even though it was my idea first and you stole it from me.
I was going to say, I took that idea from you.
I
definitely took that from you. That's nice. Wow, Mr. President, that is That is really cool to know. This is a personal question that I wanted to ask. The question is, what kind of music do you listen to? Are you a Cardi B fan, or is she a little too colorful for you? She's like younger generation stuff. Are you more of like a Michael McDonald kind of fan? Ah, speaking of the McDonald's.
There you go. I like that. I like that. I like McDonald's. Michael McDonald.
Yeah.
Is it Michael McDonald or
Michael McDonald? I think
Michael McDonald. Just for that alone, I like. He was in a band, right?
Something. I don't know.
I like his voice. I like his voice.
Yeah.
You keep forgetting I'm not in love anymore. Right?
I like it.
Oh, that's it. That's it.
Wow.
So that happens to me a lot.
We have a great technical team. That's
incredible. That was fast, I have to tell you.
Who do you listen to, though? Because all our musician fans want to know, like, what does Donald Trump listen to?
What do you mean listen? You know, people actually sit down and listen to music?
If you ever go into a car and you put on a radio, well, I guess you don't drive anymore. You have people that drive you.
Right.
But, you know, do you listen to music at all in the day?
No, but I know Kid Rock, and I know Ted Nugent, and I know they make music.
Oh,
I've never heard it, but...
They're big fans of yours.
They're huge fans.
Huge fans.
Kid is a big, big fan.
His dad is a fan of my band.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
He came to my show a bunch of times.
That's
very
fantastic.
Cool guy.
I like Tony Bennett. I like Tony Bennett. I like Sinatra.
Very
I like
good.
All the classics. I don't listen to them, but I.
You're
you know,
a classic guy, dude.
Thank
I
you,
love you.
Thank you. Thank you. Is there anybody I should be listening to?
You should be listening to the Bronx Wanderers.
Oh,
you
of course,
be
of course.
To,
you
no,
guys,
I'm just kidding. I'm
your
just
show is incredible.
It's okay.
I have heard so much about your show.
Oh, thank you.
I've never
that.
Seen it, but I hear it's incredible.
Well, we're gonna try to get you out there. We're gonna try to fly.
And you're
out
crisscrossing
there.
The country, from what I understand.
We're trying. We just got back from Chicago.
Chicago, tremendous city.
We didn't go to Baltimore, right?
Right, no. What a shithole that is, right?
I know, what a shithole.
But I have to tell you, what's the best thing about Chicago? Trump Tower, you got it. Tallest building in the city.
I couldn't walk around that entire time without seeing your building.
It's right there. It's right in the center.
It's right in the center.
If it's not a Trump hotel, it's a dump hotel. That's what I always say.
Nobody knows real estate better than you, man.
Nobody. Nobody. Wow. And I know Chicago like the back of my head. I mean, most of it's a dump, but that part is the best part.
I agree. Chicago definitely isn't a New York.
You know, they turned the river green on St. Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day, I do know that.
That's disgusting.
They haven't been able to get that green out for about 20 years.
I know, it's sick.
It is really pretty sick.
It's a beautiful city 6 months out of the year. Other 6 months, freezing cold.
Yeah, freezing I agree. Cold. I thank God freezing. I went in the summer, I really do. I heard this little rumor about you. I honestly can't imagine
fake
living
with news.
Living
if it's a
that.
Rumor, it's a fake news.
Well, I heard that you never touch alcohol or drugs
no,
or
I don't,
anything,
I don't
ever.
Drink. I don't drink.
Which is shocking.
Really? Why is
considering,
it shocking? I'm very together. I don't want to take anything that's going to be make me less me or more. You know what I mean? I want to be in control 24-7.
We definitely don't want to do anything.
24-7.
That you makes know, you less
people
you.
Say I'm uptight, but I don't think so. I think I'm very relaxed.
What, are you kidding me? You had basketball teams over football teams. You gave
everybody's,
them McDonald's.
Yeah, and they loved it. And they loved it. And the fake news made it seem like it wasn't right, but they all loved it. They all loved the burgers. They all loved the fries.
And you paid for that out of your own pocket.
Out of
from
my
what I
own pocket, which I reimbursed you people for.
Yeah, right. Well, thank you for that. We right. appreciate that.
That's
but
an
wow.
expense. That's an expense.
That just really is so good for you that you never did any drugs
nope,
or anything
nope,
bad.
No, well, my brother was an alcoholic and he died from alcoholism.
That's
so
right.
I swore I would never drink
that's
again,
right.
unless I had to.
Yeah. You lucky, know? Lucky.
Can you imagine me drunk?
The
decisions I'm making now are, you know.
I would pay money to see you drunk. I would pay money.
I've heard that before.
I think we should just
I've
hang out one night and, like, you know, when you win your second term or your third and fourth and fifth and sixth term.
President for
when
life.
When you're president for life, we should hang out and have, like, a fun night. If
Absolutely.
You come back to the show and, you know, you give me the ratings that I want.
Absolutely. You're going to get incredible ratings. These ratings are going to be. And by the way, the studio audience here, I was told you usually have 20, 30 people. There's, like, 1,000 people
it's
crammed
actually,
in the
It's actually
space.
The largest crowd you've ever had.
You folks can't see it. You folks at home can't see it, but there's so many people.
It's well over like
so
200 people in the city audience. So
we got Don Jr.'s here, Eric, Ivanka, Jared's here. That's my son-in-law, Jared. That's my son. You know, I've never heard him speak. Ever.
Not many people
I've
have.
I've never heard him speak.
No.
I heard I do at the wedding, and I was heartbroken. But other than that, that was it.
Very cool. Well, you know, he doesn't have that well of
Isn't she attractive?
Voice.
What an attractive girl.
She is. She's
very beautiful.
I think that's your daughter.
And smart. That's why it's my daughter.
That is your daughter.
Do you know she works for free in the White House? Senior advisor. And she doesn't get paid. So I call it bring your daughter to work day every day. Every day is bring your daughter to work day.
I like that. I like that. Yeah, that's really, really, really
you
good.
You have kids? You have
I don't. I am a kid. I'm still a kid.
You are still a kid.
Yeah.
You're pretty young.
I'm pretty young. I don't know. I'm 31. Is that young?
No, that's not that young anymore.
It's not that young.
You should
right?
really
31
like,
isn't the new 21?
No. I don't
like
tell you that stuff.
I mean, you know, you're like 70, but you're more like 50. You're
I know.
Like
I have so much energy. And I'm the youngest president in the history of presidents.
Can you imagine debating Sleepy Joe Biden?
Like, no, how I can't. He's going to put him to sleep. You know what? His white teeth are going to like blind me.
I know.
And his hair plugs, too.
He's such a boring dude.
This is real, by the way. This is real.
I feel like...
Sleepy Joe. What has he done? Nothing. Other than being vice president for 8 years and a senator for 24, he's really done nothing. Nothing.
Yeah.
And he's a doctor. But other than that, he really hasn't accomplished much.
He's definitely a boring Joe. If you run against him, I feel like you will probably
He'll
get
probably
that win.
He'll probably be dead before the election.
He probably won't even make it to
November.
Who wants
an 80-year-old president? Not me.
Yeah.
Not me. I mean, for me, yes, but not me.
No, just keep golfing. Right. That keeps us all safe. Next question. Speaking of that, I know like...
By the way, you're very good at this. You're very
you.
Good at reading
I try.
Questions.
I try.
Very good at reading.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm not a reality star.
You must be hooked
star.
On phonics.
I'm not a TV star like you, but I try to be.
No, very few people are. Highest rated reality show ever, The Apprentice.
It is.
Highest rated ever. I made NBC a lot of money.
You did make them a lot of money.
Now they're being very mean to me on MSNBC.
You should have a reality show now in the office.
Don't you think we can make
show?
We should make.
You'd be killing it.
We could make a fortune.
Yeah, then we could send all that money to Baltimore and fix the place.
And fix it up, because it's a dump. What a dump.
That was a total bullshit. We're not fixing it up.
Yeah, no.
Baltimore.
We're not fixing anything.
You can't fix Baltimore. No. So the one of the few things that I've been like trying to follow with you in your presidency is... There's a lot of scandal. There's a lot of action. Let me put it like that.
Which you like.
There's
which
a
people
lot of action.
Like. Keeps you engaged.
You're always in the news. You're never not in the news.
Exactly.
One of my favorite things that were in the news is you had no idea about payments to Stormy Daniels. She was just blonde. Yeah, you know her. But then your own lawyer, Michael Cohen, secretly audio recorded the meeting and talked about the payments, and then he turned on you. What a rat.
Well, I have to say, thank goodness that he did record it, because if he hadn't recorded it, I wouldn't have remembered.
Yeah.
And there would have been no evidence.
And it wouldn't show that you're innocent.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Because clearly what everybody heard from the tape is, you know, you're innocent.
Right. I have to, that's why you pay people off, because you're innocent. You don't want people impugning your innocence. That's why you pay them not to impugn your innocence. Do you see what I'm saying? So $130, by the way, that's not a lot of money, $130,000.
No, that's
chicken, not a lot. You know what I mean?
Shit.
She's in porn. She makes probably at least that every 3 or 4 years.
Yeah. I mean, all your kind of scandals can be listed like Friends episodes.
Really?
Yeah. Because all the Friends episodes are like the one where Joey does this, the one where Rachel does that. So, like, you can be like the one where you said there was no Trump Tower Moscow. That's an episode.
That's a good one. That
was
a
really good episode.
That was a good episode.
That was. You also got the one where the kids, you know, are in cages. That's a... It's a dragging on episode.
But everyone loves kids in cages. You know what
that's
I mean?
True.
That's
I mean,
funny.
That's
funny.
Why I don't
the
have
photo,
kids.
Have you seen the memes? Very funny.
The memes are very funny. The one where you fire James Comey and tell Lester Holt on TV you did it because of the Russia investigation. I'm sorry, Russia witch hunt.
But that just shows how honest I am. Shows how honest I am.
Well, again, I mean,
I never lie. I told the truth.
Two years.
When I tell the truth, everyone gives me a hard time. When I bend the truth, everyone gives me a hard time. You know, I'm the victim here.
It's the liberal media.
It is. They're terrible.
They always give you an unfair shake.
Thank God for FOX.
Thank God.
Thank
but again, what
and
is,
you, you've been very honest. You've been very good to me.
I'm a fan. I got to admit, I am a fan.
You're a huge fan.
You are just a lump of comedic gold.
So much entertainment, so much engagement. Aren't you paying more to governance and the presidency than under Obama, under Barack? Wasn't he boring?
He was definitely boring.
Boring? And you probably didn't check in every few hours to see what he was doing.
I definitely wasn't involved
in
all the
politics time for
me. As much. I wasn't involved in politics as much when he was around. He was kind of sleepy, too.
Sleepy guy.
A little sleepy guy.
Under the radar.
You're
not
far
me,
from
though.
Sleepy.
Far from sleepy. I'm wide awake. I'm the greatest president in the history of presidents, other than the late, great Abe Lincoln, whose wife was maybe a three. Maybe a three. On a good day. On a good day. Your girlfriend's smoking hot. I've seen her. Very nice. Very attractive.
I wouldn't do Mary Todd with your mushroom.
No. And depressed. Mary Todd was depressed. I didn't know she liked mushrooms, but, you know, they ate a lot of weird stuff.
They did eat a lot of weird stuff.
She was short, too. I've seen the paintings. They're all over the White House.
They are.
We're going to get rid of those paintings. They're very depressing.
I mean, I have to say, though, I really do have to give you credit between half of your presidency so far was completely enthralled in investigation, constant from the House. You had like the biggest rap in the midterm elections, like the most people leaving the Republican Party. Fox News is having more people. And all this you have accomplished with like a fourth grade reading level. It's like, it's incredible.
Well, it just
it's relatable.
You.
I'm not saying that as a dig. I'm saying that as to all your fans and followers, you talk to them.
I do.
You
I
know
talk
how
to the
talk
people.
To them.
I talk
and that's
to
why they love you.
The people. That's why they do love me. Because I'm a regular guy. I'm a regular guy. I know what it's like. And by the way, I'm just like you. I'm just like you. Other than the fact that my father
gorgeous.
Gave me a $14 million interest-free loan and left me $355 million when he died. Other than that, I have no real money to speak of. So I know what it's like to be poor.
You got
like
a very, you started out like everybody else.
Everybody else. And I built my business up.
Rags
totally
to riches,
rags
baby.
Rags to riches, and now I'm the president. It just shows you that if you put your mind to it, you can do anything. Positive mental attitude. And I'm so positive, you can tell from my tweets.
You're so positive.
Very, very positive.
So positive.
Very
and
positive.
And you got to keep that squad in check because they are getting a little ridiculous.
They
with
are. These women are just
thing.
Getting.
Yeah, they're like, they've
Green
they've
New
very,
Deal, please. If I lose to the Green New Deal, I deserve it. The windmills, the women, you know about this,
yes,
right?
Yes, I've
they're
heard.
Killing birds.
I've heard from you.
They're killing birds. The windmills are killing birds. There's like, it's like a bird cemetery.
It is.
Below these windmills.
They're killing
you know
birds
I mean?
And they kill golf courses. Because I remember you had a golf course in Ireland.
Yes.
That they wanted to put windmills on the
out
course.
Out in the ocean. Out in the, not on the course. Out in the ocean. It would have ruined the view.
It would have ruined the view.
And that hum.
Yeah, nobody wants that
gives
hum.
Gives you cancer.
It does.
Gives you cancer. The hum gives you cancer. It kills birds. Now, coal, that's a fuel I can get behind. That's a fuel I can get behind. Clean coal. Clean coal.
Clean
you know, they
coal.
Take the coal and they scrub it and then they burn it and there's no residual after effect. There's no carbon dioxide, monoxide, whatever that is.
That's one thing I love about you. You're very progressive where you don't want to go clean energy. You don't want to go windmill, solar, all that crap.
No.
You know, all that.
Who wants that? Who wants to use the sun?
All that stuff.
Because it's going to go out eventually.
Yeah.
And then you'll be like, oh, now what do we do?
Exactly.
Now what do we do?
Why mess up a good thing?
Right, right.
So
right.
We should be like, you know, we should be going more into coal. We should be drilling more.
Yes, drilling
maybe
more.
Maybe we should be drilling in... like national parks, like maybe Yellowstone.
Well,
it's got some great oil.
You know, breaking news, I've already given up a lot of national parks so we could do that.
You did.
Under
you did.
Zinke.
You did.
Under Zinke.
You did. That's
Zinke.
Your EPA guy?
What a great
guy?
Name. Well, it was. Zinke. What a great name.
How
Interior.
Many EPA guys
the
are we through right
the
now?
Secretary. Well, we had the one guy, but he left. But Zinke was the interior guy, but he made it possible to give up a lot of the federal land.
Ron Pruitt was great.
What
he
a
was,
great smart guy.
That guy rolled
smart
back
guy.
More
what about
regulation
Ross?
Than anybody.
What about Wilbur Ross? Is he
Wilbur
great?
Ross is killing. I feel, by the way, I'm so sorry that you didn't get that question on the census in time. You know.
Well, you know, it just shows you. Well, everyone's upset. Like, what's wrong with asking people if they're an American citizen?
No, they should answer that.
They should answer
100%.
That. 100%. 100%.
And if they're not,
agreement.
You know, then they're not going to vote.
Right.
They're not going to fill up the census. And then, you know, the real Americans get the district.
Exactly. Exactly.
I agree.
You're smart.
I am.
You're very smart.
You should hire me.
I know it's political
I heard
stuff.
There's like 50 openings.
A lot of openings. A lot of openings. You know, it's tough. We're trying to get the best people. Trying to get the best people.
Oh, man.
It takes time to get the best
and
people.
I feel bad that... your sweetheart, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, no longer there.
Well, you know what? She just wanted more time to not answer questions at home.
Yeah. You know? Well, she took some hefty vacation days in that place. What did she go, 100 days without a press briefing?
Another record.
Did that help
another
you?
Record.
That was a record.
Helped me a lot.
It
helped me a lot.
You're totally right.
Well,
Dad.
A lot of records. We've set a lot of records at my White House.
You have set a lot of records.
A lot of records. I was out of the White House. I'm the first president to be out of the White House in 11 days golfing at his own course. That's a record. I've
Speaking
golfed more
that,
than any other president. That's a record.
I think you're at $111 million with golf, man. That's awesome.
I
By the way,
that,
all
I
that,
that
golf,
day.
Are you good?
Oh, I'm tremendous.
Yeah?
I'm tremendous. I could have been a professional golfer if I'd put in the time. But, you know, I wanted to build buildings and build
God, you would have made that sport so exciting.
Yeah, I have to tell you, I keep getting better and better and better. I'm missing the ball much closer now.
That's very good. I'm very proud of you. Very proud of you. I got to ask, what is like your favorite accomplishment that you've had over these past
Ivanka.
Few years? Ivanka's your favorite accomplishment.
She's my favorite accomplishment.
She really is. She's really got her shit the most together.
She
hasn't
so
left.
She's so amazing.
You know, she doesn't get in any scandals or anything,
which is great. Her and Jared, other than that whole thing with China and that building in New York and his dad
and
being arrested.
And all that.
Other than that.
Fake news.
Yeah. She's doing great. And so many accomplishments. You know, we're undoing health care for millions and millions of people.
I don't want to pay for pre-existing conditions. I'm a healthy guy.
Exactly.
They should get off healthcare, make mine cheaper, and if they got to go, they go. We're overpopulated as it is.
Yes. You know, people are going to die. It's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
It happens every day. People dying right now.
We just
got to
hope more people die in California and
New York. And by the way, I love California. I just don't like the people in California.
Yeah.
Don't like them.
Nobody does. Because we totally could have fixed that fire with a rake.
If they raked that floor, there would have been no fires. It would have been great. Smokey the Bear be unemployed right now. But instead, you got people, you got leaves, you got trash, you got hippies, you have people living in tents, which is terrible. Who wants to live in a tent?
Nobody.
Why do people camp? I don't get that. Why do you camp?
I don't get it.
There's no electricity. You got to make your own food. That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
I agree. We should outlaw camping.
I think you're.
Drill where all the campsites are.
Let's make them drill.
Drill, baby, drill. I like that. Put them to work.
They're so stupid.
Damn, this guy's
a genius. They're so stupid. They're camping. Let's make them drill.
God.
Let's make them drill.
I don't know if you've heard, but there's this guy in Las Vegas. His name is John DiDomenico. He impersonates you.
Yeah, I've seen him on a bunch of stuff. I've seen him on TV and all that.
On TV.
Terrible, absolutely.
You think he's terrible?
He's horrible. I mean, out of all of them, he's the best, but he's the worst of the best. He's like the world's tallest midget. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's not a big claim to fame. Everyone thinks they can.
But the guy gets ratings. He's on Conan. He's on Australia.
Right.
The guy's everywhere.
Well, I will say this: he's better than Alec Baldwin.
He is.
That Alec Baldwin is terrible. He's terrible. He's such a hack.
Yeah.
At least that DiDomenico guy is nice. He's nice to me.
I've heard those things.
Very fair.
Believe it or not, I don't know if you've heard, Mr. President, but John did release a new movie on Amazon Prime. It's called Fake News, A Trump Story.
Right. I haven't seen it, but I actually heard it's pretty much... pretty good picture of me.
It would mean the world to me, Mr. President, if you were to watch, rate, and review it. That's what people do. I'm going to do it.
Okay.
You should check it out. And if we hate it, you can come back on the show. We can rag on the show. We can totally make fun of him if it sucks.
Okay, so it's Fake News, A Trump Story, and Amazon Prime.
Prime, right.
That means you have to have Prime.
Right.
I don't have it, but Ivanka will give me the password.
She'll get you it.
Yeah, she'll get it.
She'll get you it. Russia.
Yeah, I'm not giving Jeff Bezos any more money.
Look at me.
Any more money.
All you got to do is look in that camera and go, Russia, just give me Amazon Prime.
Russia, this went on. Russia, give me Amazon Prime and find Hillary Clinton's emails.
I swear to God, that's probably going to happen in 24 hours. You will have Amazon Prime in 24 hours.
I'll probably have a disc delivered with the show on it.
Jesus.
You know, and then I'll just review it that way.
Well, wow. I'm just with the president, man.
I know. It's crazy. And I'm so happy to be back here in Las Vegas.
Well, thank you for making time to come on the show.
I love it.
Very friendly to you on the show.
I know, and I appreciate that.
We try.
You've been very good to me. I've tried. And I love coming back here to Las Vegas. And you know that Las Vegas is a Hispanic term. You know that, right?
I had no idea.
It means hookers and blow.
Hookers and blow.
That's why. Not that I do. I don't indulge in, I indulge in one of those. But that's why I love to come back here to Las Vegas.
Very good.
And of course, we have Trump Tower right on the strip.
Trump Tower. You should totally hit cook me up with a room there.
Oh, absolutely. We can do that.
You're so awesome, Mr. President. Well, I want to thank you again. I want to just remind you, you should totally look up John DiDomenico's new story, Fake News, A Trump Story, on Amazon Prime. Great friend of the show. Sir, keep killing it.
I wish you
1,000 more years of Trump reign.
Oh, Ivanka will be next after my lifetime serving.
Thanks so much for being on the show. We salute you. Make America great again.